This here is Judith's Hedge in Cambridgeshire. Judith was the niece of William the Conqueror, and in 1070 she asked for this hedge to be created. And so this is one of the oldest known hedges in Britain. And it's botanically rich. There's some clematis, there's dog rose, there's some hazel here, there's maple through in the back there, there's viburnum, there's hawthorn and blackthorn, and then there's an oak tree up there, and then there's wild service tree here. It's a nice wild service tree. So there's a remarkable diversity of species in this small section. And Max Hooper studied 227 30-yard, that's 27.5 meters, hedge sections, and showed that the main determinant of the diversity in these sections was the age of the hedge. And that was more important than the climate or the soil conditions or features like that. So then he produced a relationship, and this became known as Hooper's rule, that you counted the number of head of species in a 30-yard section and multiplied by 110, and that gave you a rough indication of how old it is. And why might that be? Well, partly these ancient hedges may well come from old woods. So this hedge here we know came from Monk's Wood, which is that ancient woodland over there. Species will arrive over time. So the maple we saw is a poor disperser and often takes a long time to arrive. And it may well be that old hedges were just created by taking from the nearby woods, and so started off as a more diverse mix. And then in the more industrial hedge planting later on, that was very much a hawthorn mix, hawthorn dominated planting scheme. So Hooper's law, Hooper's rule, gives a bit of an indication, but we shouldn't take it too seriously. A whole host of other factors will play a role. So we really want to use a set of cues to age hedges. So there's things like the historical records. So this was a parish boundary, and we can look those records up. We can look for particularly old trees, coppice trees, pollarded trees. We can look at the ground flora. So here we've just seen dog's mercury. There's also bluebell and wood anemone that are indicators of ancient woodland, so suggest that this is a very old habitat. And then you can look to see how wiggly it is. And you can see this is a wiggly hedge, which is characteristic of old habitats, because they're going round streams, boggy areas, old trees, ancient fields, whereas later hedges tend to be much straighter. So this doesn't really apply very well to new hedges. So I've planted a 4,000-year-old hedge in our garden. But we can identify where hedges seem to be ancient, and many hedges are really old, and we can use a mixture of these different historical landscape and species diversity features to try to identify these old bits of the landscape.